Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be my 34-week pregnancy update. This week has officially been the hardest week for me mentally, emotionally, and 100% physically. I don't ever remember getting to this point with Landon. I mean, then again, my situation is very different now compared to what it was then. I'm working a totally different kind of job. I was working for United Airlines my first pregnancy, and in between flights, I could sit down and take breaks. And now that I'm serving again, I'm constantly on my feet for like 5+ hours, just depending on my shift. So that is really, really straining me. I'm still trying to go hard at work though. I really enjoy my job and the people I work with, and I don't really want to leave too early. This past week, I have rarely slept. It's driving me absolutely insane. I'm not falling asleep until like 2:30 in the morning, and then I will wake up, oh my gosh, probably every 45 minutes to an hour to pee. It's horrible. Like, I just think, I know it's just gonna get worse because he's gonna get bigger and he's gonna put more pressure on my bladder, but it's just ridiculous. And then I can't fall back asleep. And it's not helping that I'm also experiencing hot flashes now. And I thought it was just because it's getting hotter outside, but I'm constantly asking Kevin, like, is it hot in here? Like, are you hot? It's like super hot. Like, we need to open a window. And after about the 15th time of me asking him, he was like, I honestly think it's just you because it's really not that hot in here at all. It's not even that hot outside. And I'm like sitting there like fanning myself like a psychopath. And the weirdest part about my sleep habits, or like the sleep pattern that's going on with me right now, is I get the biggest burst of energy around like 10 o'clock and I am in extreme full-blown nesting mode. I was on my hands and knees the other night in my kitchen scrubbing the floorboards. I've also been experiencing this extreme numbing sensation in my legs, and it only happens when I'm sleeping. I wake up and I just can't feel them, but I wake up because it's painful. It feels like a lot of pressure, and I actually ended up reading that if the baby's positioned a certain way, or depending on how low they are, they can like put pressure on your nerves, and it can cause like your limbs to just not work, I guess. I got out of bed to use the bathroom and I had to physically lift my leg over the bed, and when I tried to stand, like, my leg gave out and I fell. And I was just like, what's happening? Like, I was so afraid. And like, Kevin was just like, it's just pressure on nerves, like, you're fine. And then my leg ended up coming back to life, thankfully. But I've never experienced anything like that before, and I've never even heard of that happening, and it's happening way more frequently, and I think it's just because of how he's positioned. I'm not really sure where he is, considering his movements have picked back up, and he is literally like just beating the crap out of me. And it only starts around like 1:30 in the morning, where I will feel like an elbow and then a leg and then like a hand and a foot, and it's like this chain reaction of just him like somersaulting or something. It's so wild. Like, this pregnancy is just crazy. I am enjoying it though. I feel like I complain a lot, but that's just because my first pregnancy was so easy. It was just a breeze. And now I'm just like, wow, like, this is why women say pregnancy is so hard. And it's because it is so physically just demanding on your body. And like, every pregnancy is different. So like, you really just experience a whole lot of like crazy things. Landon has become super attached to me as of recently. It's the weirdest thing. I don't know if it's a phase. I don't know if he can like sense or like tell that something big is about to happen. I'm not sure what's going on, but he is just all over me. He's really never been a huge cuddler. He's just always on the move, like one end of the house one second and like in a completely different room the next. But he will just lay with me and he'll just hang out. But the bad part about all of this is that if I leave the house, it's a full-blown meltdown. But I can't leave his sight. I can't use the bathroom. I can't go to the kitchen. I can't step into my room to grab something without him darting towards me, crying, saying my name. He like doesn't want me out of his sight. And it breaks my heart because when I leave for work or if I go to the store or something, like, I just hear him cry when I leave, and it's so sad. I hate it so much. I'm just hoping that he gains his little independence back, because it's just gonna be really, really, really difficult for me with this new baby coming. He just doesn't wanna do anything or go anywhere without me, and it breaks my heart, especially when I have to leave the house, because he's just so sad. And even when Kevin's home, like if Kevin tries to bathe him and he sees me go into the room and close the door, like he immediately starts crying for me. And I'm just hoping that once his brother gets here, like he will have some sort of independence back, because it's just gonna be physically really demanding for me if he's still clingy. I've talked about this in my previous updates probably multiple times, but you guys, my pubic bone is in so much pain. It feels extremely bruised, and every single step I take, it feels like I'm being electrocuted down there. I don't know how to explain it. It's called SPD, and it's basically the relaxant hormone that like loosens your ligaments to help the baby during birth. And I didn't experience this last time, and it's killer, you guys. Especially when you're like nesting and organizing, which means you're like moving around a lot, kind of like stressing your body out a little bit, it gets so much worse. And I'm in that intense nesting stage right now. And by the end of the night, I just wanna like chop my lower half off because of how much pain I'm in. And it keeps me up in the middle of the night. I try to like wedge a pillow in between my legs to relieve like pressure, but it's just like muscular pain. And it's also not like the top of my pubic bone that hurts, it's like underneath. So I know that there's really nothing I can do. I've tried to take baths, I've tried to relax, but it'll just hurt for days, and it's just, oh, I can't wait for that to be over. I'm having so many Braxton Hicks, you guys, and it's making me nervous because I don't know if that means like labor is coming soon. I don't know what's going on, but they hurt. They're like uncomfortable because of how tight my stomach gets, and they last so long, but I'm having so many of them, and it's like they come like right after one another. They are so intense and they just last forever. And I know that's really common like towards the end of your pregnancy. I guess I don't really realize that I'm way farther along than I think I am, but I just feel like this shouldn't be happening until later on. So I'm a little bit nervous. So I've officially decided on a theme for a baby's nursery, and I know it's taken me long enough, but I just wasn't really sure what I wanted to do. But I have a good idea, and I'm not gonna go into detail because I do plan on sharing it. But his crib and wallpaper and everything should be here by next weekend. And I definitely 100% plan on filming a lot of organizational nesting videos, all that good stuff. I'm just so excited to finally like get my hands on all the little baby clothes. They are all in his room right now, and I haven't seen them in so long. So I'm just so excited to like take a little walk down memory lane, and hopefully I don't cry because Landon is so big. And he used to be so tiny. I'm just, oh, I can't wait for newborn snuggles. Like, I'm so excited. My little babies, I'm so excited. Like, I just can't wait. I also have to pack my hospital bag, so that is on my to-do list. So that's all for this week's update, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Go ahead and subscribe down below to stay connected with me throughout my entire pregnancy. I also make other lifestyle, motherhood kind of videos on my channel, but give this video a like, and I will see you in the next one.